axillary artery is the continuation of subclavian artery. It extends from the outer border of the first rib to the lower border of the teres major muscle, where it continues as brachial artery. The pectoralis minor muscle crosses the artery and divides it into three parts. That is, first part, which is also called superior or proximal to the muscle. Second part, posterior or deep to the muscle. Third part, which is also called inferior or distal to the muscle. Relations of axillary artery. Relation of first part, anterior. First part, skin. Superficial fascia, platysma, and subclavicular nerve. Deep fascia, clavicular part of pectoralis major. Clavipectoral fascia with cephalic vein, lateral pectoral nerve, and thoracoacromial artery. Loop of communication between the lateral and medial pectoral nerves. Lateral and posterior parts of the brachial plexus. Medial, axillary vein. First part of the axillary artery is enclosed, that is, together with the brachial plexus, in the axillary sheath, derived from prevertebral layer of deep cervical fascia. Relation of second part, anterior, skin, superficial fascia, deep fascia, pectoralis major, pectoralis minor, posterior part of brachial plexus, subscapularis, lateral part of brachial plexus, thoracobrachialis, medial part of brachial plexus, medial pectoral nerve, axillary vein. Relations of third part, anterior, skin, superficial fascia, deep fascia. In the upper part, there are the pectoralis major and medial root of the median nerve. Posterior, radial nerve, axillary nerve in the upper part, subscapularis in the upper part, tendons of the latissimus dorsi and the teres major in the lower part. Lateral, thoracobrachialis, musculocutaneous nerve in the upper part, lateral root of median nerve in the upper part, trunk of median nerve in the lower part, medial, axillary vein, medial cutaneous nerve of the forearm and ulnar nerve between the axillary artery and the axillary vein. Anterior circumflex humeral artery and posterior circumflex humeral artery. Applied aspects. Axillary arterial pulsation can be felt against the lower part of the lateral wall of the axilla. In order to check bleeding from the distal part of the limb, that is, in injuries, operations, and amputations, the artery can be effectively compressed against the humerus in the lower part of the lateral wall of the axilla. Thank you.